All right, welcome back to Python Module 2, Programming Logic. I'm your professor, Professor Fiske. Please hit that like and subscribe button. It helps tremendously to let me know if my content is still valid and if you liked it and you want more. Okay, so in the last micro lecture, we went over data types, but now I want to take a big step back and I want to talk about variables and constants. So we've already, in a very roundabout way, spoke about variables, right? Our variables, first name and last name are here, age is here and whatnot. Great, these are variables. They are storage locations, which store the value, which is on the right, to the variable name on the left. Fantastic. Well, what in the hell is a constant? Well, remember when I talked about that idea of immutability? Immutability, or being immutable, is a thing that is built in to all programming languages. And the one thing I would say is that when it comes to the immutability of a variable, that's where constants come in. So what is a constant? A constant is a variable for which the value cannot be changed after it's been initialized. So what you see here in all three of these lines is the initialization of the variable with a value. If I didn't have the value on the right, it would just be a declaration. So if I didn't have these values and I just had first name, this is declaring the variable. Obviously in Python, this is not allowed. You are not allowed to do this. You cannot just declare a variable in Python. You actually have to initialize the variable. This is a good practice. So when you get to C# and Java and C and all these other languages that you want to learn, you don't make the mistake of initializing a storage location without giving it the value it needs to hold. This is why Microsoft and Chrome have massive memory leaks in their code. Okay, great. Well, what makes a, variable a constant is when you can't reassign a value to it. So if you look at age in this case is 90, right? But I can also reassign a value to it again and say, oh, oops, I would like to use this variable again. I would encourage all of you to reuse your variables. Be environmentally friendly. Recycle. Pick up your garbage. Don't keep on trying to create new variables just because you think you need it, because you don't. As you see here, when I assign a new value to the variable age, it wipes out the old value and replaces it with the new value. Quite nice. When you have a constant, you cannot do this. Reassignment to a variable is not allowed. But there's one problem with Python that you need to understand. You really can't prevent reassignment in Python. Constants exist in a lot of other languages, but in most scripting languages, constants do not exist. That doesn't mean we don't try to mimic the idea of constants. How do we do that? Well, in other languages, normally we would have a specific way of writing the constant's name, the variable name, so we know it's a constant. So let's say, for instance, wink, wink, you're doing an assignment that says you need to calculate the gratuity of a specific bill. Well, in order to do that, what you essentially need to do is you need to create a percentage by which the gratuity would be determined. So, as you see here, this is the nomenclature that I would use for a constant. There are no spaces. The constant is not bunched up with itself. There's an underscore in there. And it's all uppercase. This is literally screaming at the other engineers saying, do not reassign to me. I am a constant. And that's it. But please understand what constants are. Constants are variables which cannot be reassigned values. In Python, constants don't necessarily exist. We can't make something final, but you can try. In the end, all we really can do is say, this is a constant, don't mess with it. But in higher level languages, we use words like final or read-only or const so that we ensure that the data type in and of itself is blocked, or not the data type, the variable is blocked from reassignment. And it would look something like this. This is gonna fail, but I'm gonna do it anyway. In C#, it's const first and last equals this and that. This is how you would define const string, I should say. Const string. This is how you would define it in C#. If it was a variable that sits inside of a method and so on and so forth. And in Java, it's final. In C, it's something else. But please understand, in the end, this is how we define constants in Python. That's all I have for you guys. As I said at the beginning, please like and subscribe. It really helps a lot. Otherwise, as I say in all my videos, good luck. Have fun. Ciao.